how to animate in Alight Motion. Please watch part 1 and part 2 to set up the character. Now let's finally animate our character. Import the model, we saved it as an element earlier. Then go to Move and Transform. There we have Location Rotation Scales Queue, Keyframe Animation Easing Reset Options, which are the things that are mentioned in the Setting Up a Character part. Keyframe. I start the legacy. Now I'll show you this manually. To animate or to move a layer, you cannot just move it and it will become animated. You need to add a keyframe. Keyframes record whatever move you make. Add a keyframe. You don't have to add it again unless you are in a different property. Now when you move the layer again, it will become animated and another keyframe will be added automatically. However, there are some things about keyframes you should know about. 1. Keyframe should appear as solid white diamonds with a dark border. 2. If it appears to be faint, then that means you are in a different property. I don't mean property as gold or treasure. By property, I mean location, rotation, scale, skew, color, effects, borders, and anything else that you can use keyframes in are a property. 3. All keyframes can be deleted at once by tapping and holding on the keyframe button, then tapping on delete. Automatic keyframes. As I mentioned before, you need to just add one keyframe and then the other keyframes will be automatically added whenever you move anything. Keyframes can be moved to a different place. Tap and hold on the keyframe, then drag to move it. You'll use rotation the most, and I'll trust you with this because if you set the character up correctly, it'll work out just fine. Eyes. I decided to show how to animate eyes and hair as well. I'll be honest, I have over 300 tutorials because there are way too many techniques and ways of animating. I have 8 tutorials on animating eyes and 5 tutorials on animating hair, and in one of the hair tutorials I've included 7 methods of animating hair. For this tutorial, I'll show you how to animate hair and eyes the smooth way. Separate the eye into upper lashes, mid lashes, lower lashes, iris, and sclera. Duplicate the sclera to move the iris within the eyeball. Select the copied scleras and add them in a group. Bring the group on top of the iris layers. Go to Blending and Opacity and select Mask. Make sure that the eye is a whole separate group because anything under the mask sclera will not be visible. Now the iris will stay within the sclera. Add has an effect called waveform for the upper lashes. Increase the magnitude, then scroll the face until the lash bends downward. The upper lashes may suffer from a series of problems, like this extra wavy one. For this problem, just decrease the spacing. Copy and paste the effect on the other eyelash and fix it. Bookmarks are used to mark a timeline. I prefer making the eye close in 0.15 seconds and open by the same duration for the blinking. Add a keyframe at the start and end, then increase the magnitude to close the eye. You may also need to use location to bring the eyelash down a bit. Then use freestyle skill to make the mask clearer really thin, and also do the same for the mid lashes. If you want to close the eyes individually, go inside the mask clearer group and then use freestyle skill. You can just use location and bring it up for the lower lashes. Here. Tap on the View Hide button to hide the eye layer. For the hair, I highly recommend the swirl effect. It is a bit hard to use at first, but it will become easy once you get the hang of it. I got to know this method from Milky's tutorial. Decrease the magnitude and increase the radius. Then place the center around the ends of it. The effect should cover at least half of the hair. rotate the effect and bring the center down a bit, or just scroll the center Y to the right to get the effect on the ends of the hair. Animate the hair using magnitude. Then do the same for the second swirls effect. Now tap and hold on the keyframes of the swirl and swirl effect and place it in the middle of the keyframes of the first swirl effect. This is putting Bahaki's delay technique that I learned from a hair tutorial. Tap on Export to save the animation.